Manhattan Project physicist Raemer Schreiber explains how the water boiler reactor was expanded to produce more power and conduct experiments. By counting neutrons produced under different circumstances, scientists could predict how the bomb might work.
The water boiler then went on to a more elaborate device. This could only run at a very few watts of power because we had no shielding. We did stand behind a 5-foot concrete wall when we were running it, but that was about the extent of it. Then we later took this same basic idea and put it in a great big cube of concrete so that we could run it up to powers of a number of kilowatts of energy, which doesn't sound like very much in terms of energy, but it's an enormous amount of radiation. So one had to have 3 and 4 feet of concrete around it. Then we used it really as you now use research reactors. We got the neutrons from this, and then one could do more realistic experiments. You could get, by that time, one actually had little sections of metallic U-235 in the form of foils or plates, and you could expose these to the neutron beam and count the secondary neutrons which came off. And in fact, later on, we did a multiplication measurement with metallic spheres, which then began to approximate more closely the behavior of the bomb itself. And one could get so-called multiplication measurements, how many neutrons appeared as a result of the collisions and the fissions inside the core for each neutron which impinged from the water boiler. And quite a number of experiments of that sort were done.